If you relied solely on mainstream gaming news, you'd believe that Stadia as a retail platform is on its way out. Well, a couple of highly interested devs and a game publisher is here to assure you otherwise. See, as Stadia continues to get strong game maker support despite media reports. This is SDO Daily, baby. Let's get into this one. What's up, people? It is your boy, MM2K of PNTS Network and Stadia Dosage, here with another SDO Daily. Before we get into this one, do us a huge favor. Hit that like button, hit that subscribe button, and rock those bells for notifications, please, so you know when we're dropping these doses. We appreciate all of y'all. Straight up, you know the deal, you know the reason, and by now you should know the slogan. What is it? We are not too proud to ask. All right, let's get right into this one. All right, so... Well, it seems like the beginning of every year, a mainstream media article tries to show you its empirical proof that Stadia is dead. These articles are very effective in dampening the spirits of those enthusiastic or curious about the platform. However, by the end of each year, the tone these pieces try to portray become eradicated. For instance, a prior 2020 Business Insider article claimed Stadia failed to land and completely ignored indie game deals. Yet by year end, their pro subscription service was flooded with them. In 2021, we had the infamous Jason Schreier report that claimed Stadia had failed altogether, was done kaput, and was on its way out. However, data shows year end, in that same year, deals like the LG TV support helped catapult further growth. And now we have a 2022 Business Insider article that claims that Stadia retail has been deprioritized and is hanging by a thread. We're not at year end yet, but already we have game makers and publishers, those on the front lines, helping to dispel these myths. So let's look at these instances and talk about it on the back end. All right. So next, let's talk about the dev enthusiasm. All right. Now, we have two developers, when queried about working with Stadia, seem more than willing and even excited at the opportunity. First, makers of the Kickstarter project, Darwake, when queried, seem more than eager to evaluate the possibility of bringing the game to the platform. What am I talking about? Let me show you something. So, this is a tweet that we sent out from Stadia Dosage, and it says, awesome for you to consider. The Stadium community loves to fund Kickstarters for games landing on the platform. Thanks for the consideration. And what this is in response to is Darwake, after being queried about coming to the platform, they said, we will evaluate, and it's initially coming to Steam and GOG. But that's not it, folks, all right? And since deleted tweets, well, let me show you something else. And since deleted tweets, they also queried us specifically about how to sign up for Stadia, and even made the statement that, hey, because this is a whole Kickstarter thing, we're a small company, not a lot of money floating around. If we get funded, we can do this thing, right? And so then I followed up with information to people at Stadia that can make this happen. And I also gave them a link to access the Stadia development page so they can sign up and become a developer for the platform. Now, those tweets detailing that, they're missing here. That's what you see. Tweet is unavailable. Now, could those tweets have been deleted because Google said, sure, we can. We can help you out. But why don't you go ahead and just remove those tweets? There's a lot going on right now out there on social media and the media. And all about us funding stuff. Let's keep that under wraps now. Let's just make this happen. I think so. So, you know, but only time will tell. All right. Next up is the developer for the forthcoming indie title Mortal Crux. The game looks awesome, it looks right up my alley, and is done by a solo dev. When queried about bringing this title to Stadia, the dev said the following, quote, let me show you something else. Thank you for the shout out. If I get the opportunity, I'd love to port to Google Stadia. And up above is right here is a snippet of the game. Awesome looking, something again right up my alley. I would love to be able to play something like this on the Stadia platform. When we talk to devs, devs like Mortal Crux and the ones that are making Darwake, about the possibility of building on the system, we always see this enthusiasm. This is totally opposite of the doom and gloom Business Insider has tried in 2020. They're trying again in 2022 with these stories to make readers believe that Stadia developer relationships are just doomed and they're just so chaotic. So there's no better people to listen to than those on the front lines. Next, let's talk about what I like to call publisher clarity. What the heck am I talking about? Well, the most direct rebuttal of media claims comes from Wired P Games. Yes, that same Wired P Games, publishers of the heavily talked about Martha is Dead game. Now, in the middle of their success with releasing this game, they've done something publishers normally don't do with a failing platform. They've gone out of their way to A, praise the platform, B, extend an olive branch to the community by creating a specific Discord for them, and C, they have taken to social media to deal with naysayers of Stadia's long-term efforts to proclaim otherwise. Here are just a few samples. Let me show you something else. So in response to Wired Productions saying this, "We love Google Stadia, but you know what we even love more? The Stadia community. We thought we should really show some love back to them. That's why we have a part of our Discord just for the Stadia chat. Come on in and join in," right? Now, shout out to my homie Darth. Good social media friend. Guy means well, big time PC person. He just happened to be at the wrong place at the wrong time. He says, "Technically speaking, Stadia works very well. Too bad it didn't catch on. Wired P Productions or Wired Productions responded immediately. They said it is a massively growing community and install base. It is here to stay." Let me read that again without any fumbles. "It is a massively growing community and install base, and it is here to stay," end quote. Now, that's not it from them. There's one more. I gotta show you my favorite. Now you may say, "Oh, that was just a nice little thing that they did for the Stadia community. I don't know what they got, you know, what they're itching to do." But I want to show you my favorite tweet that just shows why their support of Stadia is so sharp. Let me show you something else. In the same tweet cycle, someone responded, "Oop, guess you guys didn't get the memo. Google Stadia is dead. Just saying." And Wired P responded, "Nope." I love it. So, again, you don't make these type of moves. You don't show this type of enthusiasm for a platform in a community that's dying. It just doesn't make sense, all right? So, with that said, let's put a nice little bow on this, and let's get into the conclusion here. All right. So why do we keep going through this year after year with the media making bold claims the beginning of each year only to say each year, "Stadia doesn't make it for another 2 years, trust me," right? They keep kicking that can down the road. If you follow our content here on Stadia Dosage, you should know the answer to that by now. But for those that are new, here it is. It's two things: stubbornness and fear. Many are too stubborn to admit their absolutist notions of Stadia being dead, out of the water, were overboard because of how resounding that claim was from them all. Secondly, others fear that a sole cloud gaming solution that Stadia presents puts the trust of your catalog in the evil hands of Google, who are known to kill everything, right? Well, first off, reports show that Microsoft is actually more inclined to kill pay-for-services than Google. Look it up. Secondly, the media needs to admit when they're wrong and stop being overzealous and so absolutist over what they don't understand instead of deciding to twist facts. Simply put, cloud gaming has too much lucrative potential for entities like Google to bow out this early. In addition, them and Amazon have the quickest route to this illustrious 1 billion gamers due to their uber successful stream platforms. You don't simply leave, you simply don't leave that on the table because of some roadblocks during the building years, period. And that's it from your boy. Let me know what you think about all this below, because like I always say, who cares what I think? But if you did like what I had to say, check out the links below to follow me. Those links will lead you to the Broadband Bullies, PNTS Network, Hard Knock Digital Culture, and yes, the Stadia Dosage. With all that said, I appreciate love all of y'all. Peace. Have a wonderful gaming day.